हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज इनसाइड आवर अर्थ। द अर्थ आवर होमलैंड इज अ डायनामिक प्लैनेट। इट इज कॉन्स्टेंटली अंडरगोइंग चेंजेस इनसाइड एंड आउटसाइड। बट हैव यू एवर वंडर्ड व्हाट लाइज इन द इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ? व्हाट इज द अर्थ मेड अप ऑफ? Just like an onion, the earth is made up of several concentric layers with one inside another. See the picture above. This is the interior of the earth. It is made up of three layers: crust, mantle, and core. Crust, the uppermost layer over the earth's surface, is called the crust. It is the thinnest of all the layers. Did you know the crust forms only 0.5% of the volume of the earth? 16% consists of the mantle and 83% makes the core. So, maximum volume goes to the core. Now, let us know about continental crust and oceanic crust. Crust is about 35 kilometers on the continental masses and only 5 kilometers on the ocean floor. Oceanic crust mainly consists of silica and magnesium. That is why it is called SIMA. SI means silica and MA means magnesium. The main mineral constituents of the continental mass are silica and alumina. SI means silica and AL means alumina. Second layer of the earth is mantle. Just beneath the crust is the mantle, which extends up to a depth of 2900 km below the crust. क्रस्ट के नीचे वाली लेयर मेंटल कही जाती है और मेंटल का एरिया 2900 किलोमीटर्स है। कोर इज द इनर मोस्ट लेयर ऑफ द अर्थ। इट हैज़ अ रेडियस ऑफ अबाउट 3500 किलोमीटर्स। नाउ कोर इज मेड अप ऑफ निकल एंड आयरन एंड इज कॉल्ड नाइफ। NI निकल एंड FE means ferrous. Ferrous that is iron. So what is the core made up of? It is made up of nickel and iron. Iron means ferrous. The central core has very high temperature and pressure. Interesting facts. The deepest mine in the world is in South Africa. It is about 4 kilometers deep. In search for oil, engineers have dug a hole about 6 kilometers deep. To reach to the center of the earth, which is not possible at all, you will have to dig a hole 6,000 kilometers deep on the ocean floor. अर्थ के सेंटर तक अगर हम जाना चाहते हैं, विच इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल टू गो, वी हैव टू डिग अ होल 6,000 किलोमीटर्स डीप ऑन द ओशियन फ्लोर। रॉक्स एंड मिनरल्स। अर्थ क्रस्ट इज मेड अप ऑफ वेरियस टाइप ऑफ रॉक्स। व्हाट इज अ रॉक? एनी नेचुरल मास ऑफ मिनरल मैटर दैट मेक्स अप द अर्थ क्रस्ट इज कॉल्ड अ रॉक। Rocks can be of different color, size and texture. Different rocks ka different color, size or texture hota hai. There are three different type of rocks: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. Word origin. Igneous is a Latin word ignis, which means fire. Igneous Latin word ignis से लिया गया है, जिसका meaning है fire. Sedimentary, it is a Latin word sedimentum, which means settled down. Metamorphic is a Greek word metamorphos, which means change of form. Igneous rocks, igneous Latin word ignis, which means fire. Now, how these igneous rocks are formed? When the molten magma cools, it becomes solid. Rocks thus formed are called igneous rocks. जब magma गर्म होकर ठंडा हो जाता है एंड इट बिकम्स सॉलिड देन द रॉक्स आर फॉर्म्ड दीज रॉक्स आर कॉल्ड इग्नियस रॉक्स देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ इग्नियस रॉक्स इंट्रूसिव रॉक्स एंड एक्सट्रूसिव रॉक्स एक्सट्रूसिव इग्नियस रॉक्स हाउ एक्सट्रूसिव रॉक्स आर फॉर्म्ड Lava is actually fiery red molten magma coming out from the interior of the earth on its surface. When this molten lava comes on the earth's surface, it rapidly cools down and becomes solid. जब molten magma from interior बाहर surface पर आता है तो वो ठंडा हो जाता है and becomes solid. Solid बन जाता है. Rocks thus formed are called extrusive igneous rocks. They have a very fine grained structure. इनका structure बहुत ज़्यादा fine और grained होता है. For example, basalt. The Deccan Plateau is made up of basalt rocks. जो Deccan Plateau है that is made up of basalt rock and basalt is an example of extrusive igneous rock. Now, what are intrusive igneous rocks? Sometimes the molten magma cools down deep inside the earth crust. Solid rocks so formed are called intrusive igneous rocks. जब molten magma earth के interior में ही ठंडा हो जाए and it becomes solid inside the interior of earth, then the rocks are formed. These rocks are called intrusive igneous rocks. Since they cool down slowly, they form large grains. Example of such a rock is granite. Grinding stones used to prepare paste, powder of spices, and grains are made up of granite. Granite is an example of intrusive igneous rock. You can look into the picture. Look into this picture. It is explaining us extrusive and intrusive rocks. This is magma chamber and here the extrusive igneous rocks are formed due to the quick cooling of magma. And as a result, these rocks are fine grained or has lack of crystal growth. On the other hand side, intrusive igneous rocks are formed from magma that cools very slowly and as a result, these rocks are coarse grained. Now, second type of rock is sedimentary rock. Rocks roll down, crack and hit each other and are broken down into small fragments. Jab rocks niche gir jate hain, toot jate hain, they hit each other. And so they got broken. जब वो pieces में broke हो जाते हैं, they form the sediments and that rocks are called sedimentary rocks. These sediments are transported and deposited by wind, water, etc. These loose sediments are compressed and hardened to form layers of the rock. These type of rocks are called sedimentary rocks. For example, sandstone is made from the grains of sand. These rocks may also contain fossils of plants, animals, and other microorganisms that once lived on them. Now, here is an important fact. Igneous and sedimentary rocks can change into metamorphic rocks under great heat and pressure. For example, clay changes into slate and limestone into marble. So, what are metamorphic rocks? Metamorphics are those which are formed under great heat and pressure when igneous and sedimentary rocks change their form. Now, let us know about the uses of rocks. The hard rocks are used for making roads, houses, buildings. Stones are used in many games. For example, seven stones, which we know as pitu, hopscotch, steppu, five stones, gitti. These are the name of some games in which these rock stones are used. Rocks are also used in making monuments. For example, Red Fort, Taj Mahal, etc. Red Fort is made up of red sandstone and Taj Mahal is made up of white marble. So, what is a rock cycle? this process of transformation of rock from one to another under certain conditions in a cyclic manner. It is known as rock cycle. Rock cycle क्या होती है? जब rocks अपनी transformation करते हैं under different conditions from one to another way, this is known as rock cycle. What is the process of rock cycle? When the molten magma cools, it solidifies to become igneous rocks. जब molten magma cool हो जाता है, it become igneous rock. These igneous rocks are broken into small particles. यही igneous rocks छोटे particles में टूटकर sedimentary rocks बनाती हैं. When these igneous and sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, they change into metamorphic rocks. Igneous or sedimentary rocks, जब heat और pressure के under आती हैं, then they form metamorphic rocks. So, what happened next to these metamorphic rocks? Metamorphic rocks, which are still under great heat and pressure, melt down to form molten magma. यही metamorphic rocks, जो still heat or pressure के under होती हैं, they again goes into molten magma. This molten magma again cools down and solidify into igneous rocks. Same molten magma जब फिर से ठंडा हो जाता है, they become igneous rocks again. So students, this was all about rock cycle. So, हमने देखा कि वन रॉक अपनी फॉर्मेशन कैसे चेंज करती है एंड इट मेक्स द रॉक साइकिल. नाउ देर आर सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स अबाउट रॉक्स. रॉक्स आर मेड अप ऑफ डिफरेंट मिनरल्स. डिफरेंट मिनरल्स से ही रॉक्स बनते हैं. Minerals are naturally occurring substances which have certain physical properties and definite chemical composition. Minerals क्या होते हैं? Minerals natural substances होते हैं जिनकी अपनी physical property और chemical composition होती है. Minerals are very important to humankind. Minerals बहुत important हैं. Some are used as fuels. कुछ minerals fuels की way में भी use किए जाते हैं. For example, coal, natural gas and petroleum. They are also used in industries, iron, aluminium, gold, uranium, etc., in medicine and in fertilizers, etc. So that's all for today's lecture. I hope it's clear to you all. Stay happy. Thank you.